The way we got around replication lag was by having memcached. I think at the time, did we run memcached on the app servers, or did we have separate memcached boxes?
I don't know about back then. Until very recently, there was no memcache on the servers.
Okay. There is memcache on the servers now?
Yes.
Okay.
There's a render cache on the servers, actually.
Oh, okay.
And now there's a stale cache.
Okay. So we transitioned, I think, over time. I think when we started off, memcache was on each app server. And then we started adding more and more app servers, and the configuration got a little weird, because like, we'd bring up a new app server, and do you want to bring up a new memcache server also, and redistribute the keys? So I think when I left, we had a bunch of memcaches that were a separate cluster. And these are the memcaches. These memcaches was used, we used memcache at Red for everything. It is like the Swiss Army knife of systems. I think we used it for definitely to avoid replication lag. You know, we'd write to the database and memcache at the same time, so that when you do an immediate redirect to a permalink page or something like that, the data is good to go if your read would have otherwise hit the slate. The other big system we had, and I think this is kind of the final big system, is we had what was called this the precompute system. Doing real-time queries against the database was too slow to generate our listing pages. So we had a whole separate database cluster called the precompute cluster, which if I recall, was just mirrored versions of all of these machines. And whenever you would submit a link to Reddit or vote, we would submit a job to this queue. The job would be something like update the front page, or update this person's liked page, or you know all these different things. Like a vote can affects a front page, it affects the new page, it affects your liked listing, all that sort of stuff. We put this job in a queue, and then what the queue would do is it would say recompute that listing's front page, or recompute that listing's rising page, or recompute that user's liked page. Some of it can be done in place without actually hitting the database. You know, if you submit a link, we just put it at the top of your submitted page. You don't have to do anything fancy. But it also affects the hotness, you know, of that link, and et cetera, et cetera. And we had a separate set of memcaches that were actually running a technology called memcached DB. And memcached DB is just like memcache, but instead of being totally in memory, it had a little disk data store. So it was like kind of fast like memcache, because it was mostly in memory, but also would persist. Data that got pre-computed would be put in memcached DB as kind of this middle layer cache so we can avoid running queries on these databases. That was basically the state of the system when I left. Lots of replicated databases, this really complicated pre-compute cluster. We had this whole separate set of databases that we could just run queries on as hard as we could, just one after another. These machines were really sad all the time. Actually, more specifically, they were literally on fire all the time. Like, these machines were hot. Like, the high load, because no query that the user would see would actually hit these machines. So we could just beat the hell out of them. And, you know, when the result is done, it hit this memcached DB. That's where we'd store the data, and the users would only hit this. So we would lose nodes here all the time because we were abusing them. We could add more, they could be slow, it didn't matter. It was out of the actual request loop. And that took a lot of load off the whole system.